So my name is Scott Bavery. I'm one of the current assistant chiefs for the City of Madison Fire Department. I've been blessed to serve the City of Madison here. I actually grew up in the City of Madison. I was born and raised here, but I've been blessed to serve the community here since 1997 on the fire department. So the City of Madison, just like many other cities throughout the country, is really trying to figure out ways to improve on emissions. I think that's our focus, is not only like the health and wellness of our people, but the health and wellness of our community that we serve and for generations and generations to come. Health and wellness is a big thing that we talk about in the fire service, mostly so for our members. And this is another, this is a big, a big improvement from where the diesel fuel. I remember when I started back in 1997, we used to have to wash the walls of the fire station. Talk about technology game changing. There will be no more wall washing in the City of Madison with technology like this. So things have come a long way with climate vents and other types of things to try to improve the health and wellness of our firefighters. But we still have a long ways to go in the fire service, and this is just another big tool, an expensive tool, but a tool that nonetheless that is really going to make it better and safer for our men and women of the fire service. Our partnership with Pierce really goes back decades. They're obviously right up the road. They're only a couple hours away. Not only are we get a chance to still talk and deal with our salespeople at Reliant, but we get to meet the engineers. Our people have direct line of communication right with the engineers. So it doesn't always need to flow through me, which is awesome. Pierce has learned a lot because of this experience of our men and women here at Station 8 driving this truck. And for that, I'm really grateful that we had the opportunity to do it because we've learned a lot as well. Presenting a product when we know it's not quite finalized yet before it goes out to sale, I think is really super beneficial. And this truck isn't the same truck we got 18 months ago. It really made some incredible enhancements. And that's really why we decided to go ahead and purchase one. One question that we get a lot from fire departments throughout the country is the cost savings. And I'm here to tell you right now that there's obviously operational cost savings, right? There's not the maintenance costs that we're gonna be dealing with. There's definitely fuel reduction. We're not using diesel fuel, even though this does have a backup diesel engine. But this truck runs 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, and yet the diesel motor doesn't ever have to kick in. It's pretty truly amazing. So I would definitely tell people, and I've told a lot of people this, before you buy a Volterra, reach out to people. Reach out to us at Madison Fire, reach out to Pierce, reach out to those companies. There's a lot to learn. I think one of the things that we learned later on is the infrastructure part. So when we added the Volterra here back in May of 21, there was some significant changes we did to make to the fire station. The process was pretty smooth, actually. I was really impressed. I wasn't the one, running the wire and putting the charger station up, but I was really impressed how smooth that was, and hats off to our engineering staff for that. Other than that, there wasn't really too many upgrades to the station. The technology has been so solid for us, so we're really encouraged to take the next step forward. So we decided to move forward with the purchase of one Volterra. We also do have plans to replace in our fleet, right? I mean, we want to continue to make this truck, but I would love to see this in our aerial ladders at some point. We want to see it in our ambulances, right? So we have a whole lot of things that here in the City of Madison, just like other departments that want to see initiatives come through. It's going to be really, really hard to go back to a traditional diesel engine for sure. And I anticipate that other communities are going to feel that as well. But we want other people to get their eyes on it. We want some other departments to run it so we can learn from them as well. Right now, I know with our relationship with Pierce, they clearly are listening to our demands. And I hope that other departments, when they're working with Pierce or any other manufacturer, that they're heard as well. Because the men and women that are driving this truck, working out of this truck, what better way to learn, from the people that are actually using it each and every day.